Hey everybody, welcome to G4G on YouTube. Today we're taking a look at Marvel Battle Lines, and it's live. So if you've been waiting for the game, or if you've been playing the downloadable version from places like APK Pure and everything like that, do know that the game is actually live. And in this video, I wanted to go through some of the untold riches you might be sitting on but not even realize it. I just realized today that I had a whole slew of stuff sitting here waiting for me in the game that I just didn't even notice until today. And I kind of shot up in diamonds and gold due to it. So before we get into that, you'll notice that I am playing through an emulator right now, and this is BlueStax Beta N. BlueStax Beta N is one of the Android emulators that pretty much handles all the things that nobody else seems to handle. For KO Player, when I would try to download the 2.0 version of the game and install it, it gives me a parsing error. Anytime you see a parsing error, it's usually because the APK is written for an OS that is not present in your Android setup. For example, you may have an APK that is set for KitKat or higher, but if your emulator is like running Jelly Bean or something like that, it'll give you a parsing error. It's basically a very vague way of saying, hey look, I'm expecting a certain Android version and you're not giving it to me. So KO Player doesn't handle the most recent APK. I just loaded it on Beta N and it logged me right into my existing account and everything's up and running. So I wanted to show you guys an event that is occurring in the game right now. So you've got a couple sets of events. You've got a 7-day check-in challenge to get the Black Suit Spider-Man as your leader. So if you log in for 7 days, you'll be able to unlock it. I didn't know about it until somewhat recently because this isn't a daily game for me yet, mostly because I cannot play it on KO Player on my laptop, which is where I do a lot of my daily things. I was kind of thinking to the point that I needed to run this off a tablet or a phone, and actually one of the tablets I tried to put it on, it wasn't available in the Play Store, which means it thinks it's an incompatible device. So now that I've got it on one or two of my main devices in here on BlueStax, which I use for Marvel Strike Force, I probably will be able to at least do things daily, although this is going to be a super casual game for me. So you can get the Black Suit Spider-Man. If you level up during the event, I think it's 10. Yeah, so if you hit level 10, you got some gold and some cards, and I'll get it again at 20 and 30. So that's the second event. The other event you've got going on is the Sinister Six Halloween event. I've done this 2 days running. It is ridiculously easy. It is stupid easy. What happens is you get these pumpkin bombs every X amount of turns, and when you use them, they take out, I think they do 800 damage in a 2x2 square. And for Sandman, Rhino, Shocker, and Green Goblin, they have these humanoid enemies that when they die, they essentially like blow up and they hit the leader. So even if you're not playing with a very, very good deck, you could just use the pumpkin bombs, which are free. They don't even cost any crystals. And then you bomb the humans. The humans kick back damage to the leader, and that's how you win. And you eventually wind up getting a goblin card at the end. I'll show you what he looks like. I just put him in my deck. So somebody was recently asking me what my deck looks like. It is pretty noobish, I would guess, by all standards over here. I have a Hellcarrier Strike, Maria Hill, Nick Fury, the Hawkeye Arrow, which is essentially like a castable spell, Agent 13, Night Nurse, Shield Commander, regular Hawkeye, Misty Knight, a sharpshooter arrow. Oh, actually, that is ready for an upgrade. Neat. I'm glad I'm doing this video. I didn't notice that before. If that goes up to 800 damage, that'd be pretty. Okay, it went up 50 damage on the low end, 70 damage on the high end. That's not too bad. Iron Man and Green Goblin. So this is the reward that you get. I've gotten it twice, so he's now up to level 2. After summoning, deal 198 damage by throwing a pumpkin bomb at the enemy with the lowest attack. Then splash 165 damage to all characters near the target. If you don't get Green Goblin, the Dark Elf Sorcerer is pretty similar. So here at 2, 627, 462, 570, 420. My guess is her stats would be somewhat similar when she goes up to 2, but it's a similar thing. After summoning, deal 180 damage by casting magic on the enemy with the highest attack and then splash 150. So it's very, very similar to Green Goblin. Green Goblin goes for the lowest. She goes for the highest. Similar concept. I have this Doctor Strange card, which is by far my best card. I just don't know that I want to put a 3 crystal in my deck. It's a lot. That's expensive in a match to go with, but he's 850, 850. After summoning, enchant all allies with a shield that prevents damage once until next turn. I feel this is an amazing, amazing card, and there's probably a bunch of people who are going to watch this video and go, shit, are you kidding? You have that and it's not in your deck? I want to put him in, but he's a 3 drop, and that's just so tough for my relatively low power deck over here. I think I'll have to work him in. I haven't really done a lot of PvP related items. It's mostly been PvE, although I will say I have been playing this well before it went global, just super super casual. I have Kamala Khan over here, who's also due for an upgrade. Forgot about that. She's a little bit like the Hell Carrier, where she does damage in a horizontal line. And she's somewhat similar to Daredevil, who does it in a vertical line. I just recently got that Night Nurse card earlier today. And that's pretty much it for my super goods. Yaka arrows, 400 damage, 2 times to his targeted enemy. So that's 800. That is pretty similar to that, except that one's up at 950. But you pay for it in the crystals. 550. Remove the... actually... Yeah, sharpshooter should go out. And Yaka should come in. The reason why I'm doing this is 400 damage twice, so that's 800 over there. Whereas the sharpshooter arrow is only 550 to 770. Same crystal cost and everything. May as well get the Yaka arrows in there. So that's kind of what my deck looks like now. If you guys notice any standout cards over here that, like, oh my god, you should use this, let me know. There's a Zemo, Black Panther, Black Maria, Shitty Colony of Ants, Black Widow. Opponent switches all action cards in hand. That could be very, very disturbing in PvP, I would imagine. There's my Green Goblin, Shadow Ninja. Weak-ass Karen Page. I've rotated her out recently because her stats are just awful. Nova Denarian. Tactical Retrieval. Retrieve targeted cosmic fragment and add 75 hit points to all nearby allies. Remove this. I'm not even really too sure how effective of a card that is, so I'm not particularly using it. So the things that I happen to discover... was one of them was related to the Spec Ops. I had this thing called a collection, and I had a whole bunch of stuff completed So as you can see here, the star collections and this car collections, I had never been here before until today. And I was like, wow. So I just cashed out a bunch of diamonds over here and a bunch of diamonds on the star collection. I still have to get Kingpin, who I think is my next mission, and the other Hydra soldier. And the other thing that I think I noticed was up here in card collection. This was another screen that I had stumbled upon that I didn't really know about. I don't know if the game ever made a nod to it. I don't know if it ever, like, guided you. But here under Shield, I got another bunch of diamonds over here. And I was like, wow, I am finding all of these untold riches that I had no idea that I had. And it could be because I've been playing the game long enough that it's changed quite a few times since I started. And I just, maybe it guides you there now, but I feel like it never really guided me to these places during any other tutorial. See, I'm level 18, so I've done a decent amount. Don't have any friends. I guess you could say I'm a complete loser. No, it's mostly because I don't know of anybody that plays it, especially when it was prior to being a full-blown game that is actually, getting a global launch and everything like that. So I am Napalm Dawn. If you want to send me a friend invite, certainly go ahead. The shop has got some hidden little things, too, that you have to scroll all the way down for. The starter offer looks pretty good. For just $5, it seems tempting to me. I may get it. The monthly package, I have no interest in. This special card deal, I see a Hawkeye over here. That might be interesting. For $10, this doesn't look too bad, especially considering that'll buff up one of my cards over here. So you get free gold every, I forget how long this is, but this is the second time I've done it today. Maybe every 20 minutes? Not too sure. Ravager Gunner. Add 300 hit points to a target by applying Asgardian Medicine. That's Scourge. Changes 300 hit points by applying Asgardian. Changes the target's attack to 200 as a side effect. So this is interesting. I have seen this in card games, where you see almost like a health and attack swap in Magic and Hearthstone. But also there is a Hearthstone card called Alexstrasza that takes you to X amount of health no matter where you are. So if you're above the limit, it's going to knock you down. But if you're at death's door and you drop Alexstrasza, you come back up. I believe it's like 15, if I remember correctly. So you might look at this and say, okay, that adds a lot of hit points, but what it does to the attack is crap. Not if you put it on somebody where bringing the attack up is going to be handy. So anybody who's sub 200 attack or very, very close to it, like Black Cat is 210, Black Widow's 220, that's not really a lot. But Dum Dum Duggan is going to gain a huge benefit out of that. Foggy Nelson would gain benefit. Saber Ninja, all these characters, the Handmaster Ninja. No, I'm sorry. I'm looking at the wrong one. Yeah. Actually, there is nobody really in particular. It's Colony of Ants. It would be very, very good on them. Get a big bonus to attack and huge amount of hit points over there. But there is no, like, real tanking mechanic in this game. There is no card that says, hey, target me. This Nova Denarian would get some good benefit out of it. The Ravager Gunner wouldn't lose too much on the way of attack. Skeletal Swordsman, Typhoid Mary over here would get some good benefit. I forget I have Wong. Wong is a somewhat new card for me. I'm kind of odd to see a named character have a crystal cost and not have any passives over here. 450, 330 for one. That's pretty good. I might want to add that to my deck. Oh, here's another one. Maria Hill. That would be another one that Asgardian Medicine would be good for. She'd gain pretty good amount from that. As would quite a few others. Night Nurse over here would get it. So Wong is a... he was a one crystal. 451, 330. Is there anybody worth taking out? See, my Nick Fury doesn't have the best stats in the world, but he has that 165 attack, which is good. I really like my Hawkeye too much. Misty Knight, I like her for her good stats, but I never really managed to play her yet where her passive activates. Here's my Hellcarrier, 700 in a horizontal line. By the way, this is everybody. This isn't enemies. I've made this mistake before. I've dropped this and I've like wiped out some of my own people. Yeah, I really don't have anybody that I could swap out with Wong except for Nick Fury. I mean, I could probably take out, you know, any of my weak no crystals. I don't know. I really haven't gotten into some heavy, heavy deck building on this one yet. But let's finish off with the shop and then we'll wrap it up. After summoning, deal 110 damage to a nearby enemy through sickle slashes. Decent crap stats. After summoning, deal 210 to 230 damage to each in a diagonally placed line with a laser blast. I think I want to spend a little money on this guy. That's interesting to see diagonal. This would be tempting for Green Goblin, except for the fact that it's... I think I want to do this too, because you do get one of his during a daily. Yeah, I think that one's worth the gold purchase over there, because if I get to do the Green Goblin thing two more days in a row, that's an upgrade for him. When you switch a card, deal 1 to 100 damage to the enemy with the highest hit points through lightning. I don't even know what they mean by switching over there. I know I have a card that tells an enemy that they need to switch, but I don't know what it means for me. Each character on the battlefield disappears. Each player summons a random character from either library to random slots four times. Remove this from battle after use in the meeting. What a weird... that's like a weird Wrath of God from Magic, except it's not destruction, it's like Chaos of God. Here are some card packs. One of them is free. Hey, look, it's Black Maria, who had... whenever I see her, I think she's had something to do with Luke Cage, but she just... she makes me think of a West Coast Avenger. Deal 190 damage with a strong kick to one enemy on the same vertical line. So it's similar to Daredevil, except it just impacts the one enemy and stops. Oh, and then there's, yeah, special operations down here. I don't even know how many special ops points I have. I should go find out. I think I would probably enjoy the game if I did play it a little bit more. I just don't know that I have the time space for it with all the other ones that I've been doing. But, I mean, it is relatively fun. I honestly don't know how many special ops points I have. Ah, 2,220. And it's good that it tells you the probability table, because that's what it's really supposed to be doing with loot boxes now. With everything that happened with Star Wars Battlefront 2 and EA and the whole major issues that are coming down on loot boxes, Probabilities are one thing they should do. So here's trial simulation. Here are trial coins. And I have zero for that. But we've got Smart Missile, Daredevil, Purple Man, Bad Cop, the Hydra Espionage Agent, and there's Misty Knight. There's another way of getting Green Goblin. They're really pushing Green Goblin. And you know what? I will bite. I like what the card does. It's not really that much of a risk for me to go for it. And now just one more daily, and that's another upgrade for him. Madam Hydra, let's see what she does. After summoning, deal 150 damage to a distant enemy through a pistol shot. Not bad. Gangster doesn't have anything interesting. We know what Black Widow does. Jane Foster. When you switch a card, yeah. I just wish I knew what that switch a card was for yourself. So there you go, that's the state of the game right now. If you've been waiting for it to pop live, it is. It is still, it's a very interesting game in the sense that some people call it tic-tac-toe. It's close, more appropriately, it is Connect Four. I've discovered that one of the best things that you can do in the game is set yourself up so that one of two things gets you a line hit. I've noticed the AI likes to do it a lot, and I'm sure I'm probably saying something ridiculously obvious over here, but if you get to that point, like where you've built an L, you have two across the bottom row, three up, say, the left side, and you can either place the top for a hit or at the bottom for a horizontal hit, that seems to be one of the best ways of approaching the game, is to set yourself up where, you know, you can do one of two or even three different things and get a leg up on your opponent. One of the best things that I think I ever have stumbled onto is where I get a diagonal that completes along with a straight direction, and you get an absolutely huge hit, but defeat the opponent leader in 8 turns. I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up now and maybe do 1-7 over here to get that final star. But I just wanted to point out to you guys some of those areas where you may have some gems lurking and didn't really know about it. And if it's ridiculously obvious, I apologize. But hey, at least I get to talk about the game and do a video on it. I started to do one on Marvel Strike Force last night, and it was going to be a video on Mystique and Sabretooth. However, my Mystique orbs that were there the day before were gone because the orbs expire. So I opened the ticket with support, and I'm told they're still attached to my account, but they're basically telling me I have to wait for the orbs to come available again, and then I'll be able to cash them out. I think it is really, really fucking stupid that you can pay for something and it's on a timer. But anyway, we'll see what happens with that. Thanks guys for checking out the video. Have a good one, everybody.